students, welcome to our next digital class session. In today's session, we are going to read the lesson, The Ransom of Red Sea, written by one of the most renowned authors, O. Henry. O. Henry is famous for writing short and humorous stories for children. The Ransom of Red Sea is a story about a little boy who is quite notorious. Ransom is the money demanded to release a captive. The boy is called Red Sea as he considers himself to be the chief of Indians. He has bright red hair, so he calls himself as Red Sea. The story tells about how the ransom of Red Sea goes for the kidnappers. The little boy is named as Johnny. Let's have a look at the characters of the story. Kidnappers named as Sam and Bill. Sam is the narrator in the lesson. Kidnapped boy, Johnny, calling himself as Red Sea. He's a 10-year-old boy with freckles on his face. Hair are the color of cover magazine, bright burning red. Kidnapped boy's father, Ebenezer Dodsett, a respectable man in the building trade and a strict and upright man. Kidnappers considered Red Sea to be the right choice as their victim because he was the only son of Dodson. Let us understand the background of the story. The Ransom of the Red Sea is written by O. Henry, who is famously known as children's author. This story is a typical example of the type of stories Henry writes. Henry's real name is William Sidney Porter. He specialized in writing humorous stories with surprise endings. At times, he uses mystery as well as an important ingredient in his writing. So many of his stories have such twisted endings that they become associated with his name. The good thing that Sam and Bill have planned in the lesson, The Ransom of the Red Sea, is the kidnapping. Early in the story, the select a quiet, sleepy town, a wealthy man with an only son, and a cave where they can keep their victim. The boy was mindfully made by the kidnappers. As he was the only son, they presumed that father would be very possessive of the child. And at that time, there was high love for the children among country people. So let's see how the kidnapping went on. They rent a buggy and approached a small boy with the promise of sweets and candy and a buggy ride. At this point, the first reversal occurs. Instead of sweetly climbing into the buggy, Johnny Dorset hit Bill the Scroll with a brick and fights violently when the two men drag him into the buggy. While he was trying to protect himself, he looked like a little bear. The 10-year-old boy, Johnny, was not easy to be victimized. He fought like a middle-sized bear in order to avoid the kidnap. Yet, even after being kidnapped, the life was not victimized for him. Rather, it was troublesome for his kidnappers. When the kidnapping was finally done and the kidnappers along with the little boy had reached their destination of kidnap, they eased out themselves and they started preparing for their meal. And that is when the boy acted like Red Sea. While having their supper, he gave them a lecture. He said, I like this point. I never camped out before, but I had a pet wild cat once and I was 9 last birthday. He spoke of all the useless things in order to prove himself to be the boss of those two kidnappers. He ordered them and shouted at them that how dare they entered his camp without his permission. He was the Red Chief of the Terror of the Plains. He said, we are playing Indians. We'll give the kid the show of his life. He was quite violent towards Bill. He attacked Bill early in the morning just to have fun. He said that he will be punishing him in the morning. So early in the morning, he woke up and he sat over the chest of Bill. Sam also woke up hurriedly by hearing the shouts and shrieks of Bill. What he saw was quite unusual. The little boy was pulling out hair of Bill with all his might. He was having a sharp knife in his hand with which the kidnappers used to chop meat. The sight was quite scary and unusual. Bill was pleading for his life. Hello students, welcome to our next digital class session. In today's session, we are going to read the lesson, The Ransom of Red Chief, written by one of the most renowned authors, O. Henry. O. Henry is famous for writing short and humorous stories for children. Bill was so eager to get rid of the boy as he was raging with anger. To ease out Bill, Sam decided to write a letter to boy's father. The letter was, Ebenezer Dorset, we are keeping your boy in a place far from Summit. It is useless for you or the most skilled detective to attempt to find him. The only terms on which you can have him back are these. We demand $1,500 in large bills for his return. The money to be left at midnight tonight at the same spot and in the same box as your reply, as hereinafter described. If you agree to these terms, send your answer in writing by a single messenger tonight at 8:30. After crossing Owl Creek on the road to Poplar Cave, Poplar Cave was the place where the boy was kept after kidnapping. There are 3 large trees about 100 yards apart, close to the fence of the seed field on the right hand side. At the bottom of the fence post, opposite to the third tree, will be found a small cardboard box. The messenger will place the answer in this box and return immediately to Summit. If you try to inform the police or fail to agree with their demand as stated, you'll never see your boy again. If you pay the money as demanded, he will be returned to you safe and well within 3 hours. These terms are final, and if you do not agree to them, no further letter will be sent. Two desperate men. So the content of the letter was quite clear. They told the father their fixed amount of demand of their ransom to feed the boy. They threatened the father that if he will fail to meet their demand, so the boy will never be given back to him. So let us see what reply was given by Ebenezer Dodson. Here comes the reply of Ebenezer Dodson to the kidnappers, the two desperate men. Gentlemen, I received your letter today by post about the ransom. You asked for the return of my son. I think you are a little high in your demand, and I will hereby make you a proposal, which I'm sure you will accept. You bring Johnny back home and pay me $250 in cash, and I agree to take him off your hands. You had better come at night, for the neighbors believe he's lost. I couldn't be responsible for what they would do to anybody they saw bringing him back. Very respectfully, Ebenezer Dodson. So such kind of reply shows how tired was the father of the notoriety of his boy. Even the neighbors were happy when he was lost, as they were having peaceful life without any disturbance. So the father demanded money to take back his boy, and kidnappers were put in even more greater trouble. Bill and Sam were so tired of the boy, they eagerly wanted to get rid of the boy. Instead of taking ransom, they were ready to give the money. Bill eagerly said to Sam, "What's $250 after all? We have got the money, so we need to give this money. I just want to be freed from this madhouse of this red chief." And finally, they took back the boy at midnight. When they knocked at Ebenezer's front door, just at the moment, the boy got the idea that they were going to hand him over back to his father. So the boy started shouting and he clung to Bill's leg. His father dragged him off gradually like a plaster, and he took the money from the kidnappers.